How many people live in the state of Florida?
Millions?
Over 20 million.
Wow, that's a lot.
Sure is. Even the earliest evidence of Native Americans in Florida dates back 14,000 years. The pioneers who found in Southwest Florida cities like Fort Myers, Naples, and Punta Gorda didn't arrive until the late 1800s.
So, who were some of those early settlers?
Let's find out!
To learn more about the diversity of Southwest Florida's early settlers, Ilijah and Jiya went to visit the Blanchard House Museum in the city of Punta Gorda. Miss Martha Bireda, the museum's executive director, was waiting to show them around, along with her assistant, Ray Ray.
Hello there, welcome. Welcome to the Blanchard House. I'm Miss Martha, and this is my special helper. Well, come on in.
What is this museum about?
Well, this is the African American Museum. It is the museum, actually, of African American history and culture of Charlotte County. And it is a museum that was the vision of my mother, Bernice Russell, because she was a descendant of the first African Americans who moved to Punta Gorda.
So that means your ancestors are actually one of the first families?
Yes, my ancestors, my great uncle Dan, was one of the first African Americans to come. 15 men came, the first 15 men that were here. 8 were Caucasian and 7 were African Americans. And my Uncle Dan Smith was one of those 7 men.
Where did they come from?
Well, the first settlers came from all parts of the South. This was what is called frontier. There was nothing here except palmetto bushes, alligators, and snakes. Our second type of fishing was sport fishing, and that was where very rich people used to come and stay at our big hotel, Hotel Charlotte Harbor, and they would go looking for tarpon. And some of our best tarpon guides were African Americans, so tarpon was very important here in Punta Gorda.
What is that up there?
Oh, that's a sawfish. That's the saw part of the fish.
Back in the early 1900s, sawfish were prized trophy fish. These strange-looking creatures grew to be quite large. Today, they are listed as endangered, and it is illegal to catch them. If you spot a sawfish, or if one happens to get tangled in your fishing net, call the Florida Fish and Wildlife Hotline at this number.
All right, come on and take a look in here. This was one of the main things, having different water fountains. And like people my age, we had to drink out of the colored water fountain. But sometimes when nobody was looking, we would just sneak and we'd drink out of the white only water fountain. And this is about travel. There was a special book called a Green Book, and that told black people where they could sleep and where they could eat, because the restaurants and the hotels were segregated. So blacks couldn't stop at just any hotel. They couldn't eat in any restaurant. But this book told us where we could stop, where we could get a good meal, and where we could spend the night.
Next stop, Punta Gorda City Hall to meet a member of the City Council. Mr. Jaha Cummings took us into the council chambers, where the business of governing the city takes place. We were curious to know if any of the city founders were African American.
Actually, 4 of them were. One's name was Obie Armstrong, another one's name was Alahu Justice, another one's name is E.C. Jackson, and the last one's name is Sam Kennedy.
What exactly did they do?
Before it was called Punta Gorda, it was called Trabue. And so when the men gathered to sign the incorporation papers, they renamed the city from Trabue to Punta Gorda. And so four of these men I noted, they actually were some of the incorporators, so they signed the paperwork so that this will become a city.
What's this for?
That's to call meetings into order.
Can I try it?
Of course.
To round out our historical tour of Punta Gorda, we headed down to History Park.
This house is called the Cigar House. And before the Spanish-American War, which was the Cuban War of Independence, actually a lot of cigar workers came from Cuba to Florida. Some went to Tampa, some went to Key West, and also some came here to Punta Gorda.
I liked this cute little house. It's called the Trabue House, and it's named after Punta Gorda's founder, Isaac Trabue. It became Punta Gorda's first post office. Then Mr. Cummings gave us a tour of an organic community garden right next to History Park.
In the 100 or so years since the founders incorporated this coastal city, much has changed in the world. Yet here, in this flourishing garden, the spirit of cooperation and inclusion that first inspired those early settlers lives on, reminding us how our shared history can serve as a foundation to building a bright and prosperous future.